Okay, let's talk about fillets and beveling. Okay, that is the best thing about this program, beyond Booleans. It has a very powerful engine on it to do some very cool stuff. So let's take a look at Edge real quick. All right, so we got this selected here. It's got a little gizmo here. If you pull it in a positive direction, you can see the count, the centimeters right there. You can see this producing a fillet, which is basically a round radius of that edge. And then if you go in the negative direction, it creates a chamfer, which is just a straight transition. So that's the cool thing about that's what really makes hard surface modeling pop, is adding all these little fillets and chamfers and bevels. It really makes it pop. It allows the light to hit it in different ways. It really sells your hard surface design. So as you notice here that this particular chamfer has gone beyond the one edge that I selected. Well, these are tangent edges, which is usually kind of a smooth transition. So as you can see, it comes down to this here and stops because it was such a harsh angle, so it stopped. So let me exit there, and if I select like this, this, and this, we'll go ahead and select him. We'll do the opposite over here. We should get a more, see, now all of it is doing the transition from fillet or chamfer. So, very cool. It's also good on blending things together. Like if you boolean things into your objects there, it really helps sell it. So let's go ahead and do a corner rectangle here. We're gonna draw him out. I didn't want a rectangle. I want a box. Same thing, except it's got depth. Bring him out like that. We're going to do B, new body, G. I'm going to move him down. We're going to change up his design just a little bit. We're going to add some bevels, or I'm going to do some fillets here. Like that. Move him in. Select him, Q for Boolean. Defaults to difference. Right click to execute. There we go. So now we got this in here. So now I should be able to just select that outer edge because everything is kind of nice, smooth transition there, and add a little fillet. Or actually a chamfer. I could select this inner one and I could do a fillet, a nice curve transition there. And you can see we got a nice little cut into our console here. Let's see, let's do cylinder, find the center of that face. We're gonna bring him out. There we go. He's already welded to it. That's cool. Oop. It can get a little crazy there, so watch out for that. There we go. He's a little more manageable now. And don't mind that faucet in. It is just the program trying to save on real small things are going to have faucet in. Okay. Curved surfaces, but it is still a perfect circle. So when you do export, it will calculate it differently and it'll come out nice and smooth. So don't worry about that. So let's offset that face so we can add a little more design in there. Push him in. I'll show you a neat little trick with a chamfer here. You could do go down to You can see the little option down here. You can do add L for a limit. It always needs two limits, so L again. Pick another side there. Boom. And you can continue adding more to it, or if you click the dot and click the other dot, it reverses the direction. That's pretty cool. Right click to confirm. Looks pretty cool. Let's see what else here. With your fillets, you got a variable fillet, which is kind of cool. This one's going to look a little weird, but we'll do it anyways. Do a corner box here. Oops. It's going in the wrong direction. Bring him out. All right, let's create a fillet. We could do add variable V, and you can change how much fillet each one is doing. And if you do V again, you can add another point, and you can have even more control over that curve or fillet. So, but that is basically fillets in a nutshell. Fillets are bevels and chamfers and whatnot. You can add so much to it. It's just an absolute pleasure being able to design all this stuff quickly and blend it so nicely into each other. It'll definitely add a whole lot to your hard surface modeling.